Hello, basketball coaches and basketball players. My name is Alan from Al's Basketball Training, and today I'm going to give you the roles of a point guard and a shooting guard. Okay, so number one, they need to be able to dribble this basketball. A point guard is the guy who's generally dribbling the ball up the court under pressure, and he's the one who's generally calling out the plays for the offense. Now, at the same time, the shooting guard is the backup to the point guard. So he is going to be sharing some of the responsibilities of being the point guard. So if the point guard is trapped, or he's getting trapped, and he needs to have a kick out, he can kick it out to the point guard, to the shooting guard. The shooting guard will get it, and he's going to be able to share the responsibilities of getting this basketball up the court. Now, myself, I started playing point guard and shooting guard when I got into grade 11. I was a center up until then. So first off, I would like to say to every single player, if you're taller or shorter at a younger age, make sure that you're practicing every single position and knowing the roles of every single position, because you never know when you're going to be changing position later on in life and you're going to be stuck. So, number one, dribbling drills. I want every single player at least 30 minutes a day. If you're serious, if you're actually serious of going pro or getting a scholarship or whatever it may be, you need to be playing basketball every single day. And at a minimum, 30 minutes of dribbling drills every single day. It's okay to get into games. That's totally fine. You need to get into games. However, if you want to improve your running drills, and dribbling drills are going to definitely help you become a better player. Whether it be two ball dribbling drills, single ball, trying to break a pylon, whatever it may be, you need to be practicing 30 minutes per day. Next is shooting. Shooting is very important. It's very important for every single position on the court. However, being a shooting guard, it quite literally is in the name of the position. You need to be able to shoot the ball, and you need to be able to do it consistently. So to be able to do that consistently, some of the tips I can give you today is to have your elbow underneath the ball when you're shooting. If it's out, wherever that elbow points, that's your aim. Your elbow is your aim. So wherever this part of your arm is shooting, wherever that's pointing, that's where you're going to be shooting. So if you're pointing out like this, like Lonzo Ball, your shot's going to be way off to the right usually. And you see this in game with Lonzo Ball. That's why he's trying to correct his shot to be in. Next is going to be having the ball roll off your middle finger. I've said this in previous videos, but if it goes off these two fingers, it's going to go right. If it goes off these two fingers, it's going to go left. If it goes off the middle, you're going to be totally fine. And if you're a serious baller, if you're really wanting to go pro or anything like that, if you're trying to make basketball your future, whether it be a professional player, coach, trainer, whatever it may be, you need to be practicing shooting at least 30 minutes a day. Don't say you don't have enough time, because you do. You may have school for 6 hours a day, but guess what? I'm editing videos for myself and other companies for 6 or 7 hours a day, and I'm still out here today for 2 to 3 hours a day because I'm fighting with those guys making a ton of noise. So you can definitely be able to make time to be able to become better at basketball if that's what your dream really is. So next is after shooting and dribbling, that's the offense. Offense wins games. However, defense wins championships. You need to get that ball to be able to score, right? If you don't have that ball, how the hell are you going to be able to score? So defense is very extremely important. Foot speed as a guard is ridiculously important. If you want to become a better defender, foot speed is where it's at. Type in on YouTube or Google foot speed drills. If I have any, I think I do. I do. I've got 2 or 3 videos on that. They're going to be linked below if I remember to link them below. If not, they're on my channel somewhere. If you want, go on my website, alsbballtraining.ca, and you're going to be able to see lists of it under videos. Next is going to be training. Training is very important. If you want custom basketball training plans, go check out my website as well. The link for that is in the description below. However, foot speed defensively is very important. Some defensive tips for you is to keep your shoulders lower than your offensive player. Keep them lower, keep your knees bent, and stay on your toes. Staying on your toes is going to allow you to be able to change direction a lot faster. If you're forcing a player in a certain direction, which I personally don't allow my players to do, I don't want my players to force other players in a certain direction, but if you are, you need to be able to turn direction really quickly. And staying on your toes is going to allow you to be able to do that. Now, what I mean by not forcing a player in a certain direction, you're playing them straight up. The only way you're going to be forcing them in a direction is if you're trying to catch up to them, in which case you're going to catch up to them, get in front, and cut them off again. Now, by not giving them a certain direction to go in, if you're basically not giving them any options. If you're forcing them in this direction, they're going to try and fake in this direction so you take your step, and they're going to be going in the other direction. That's why I don't like my players forcing other players in a certain direction. Now, you can force a player. I've seen this a few times, and I've done this a few times myself, where the other player has no left hand, so I'm forcing him right. And we're saying, why would I force him right if he has no left hand? Why wouldn't I force him left? Because all he's going to do is force or fake you left. You're going to go left, and he's going to be all screwed up. Now, the only time, or you're going to be all screwed up because he's going to have a whole right lane to go down. However, if you're forcing him left, you need to be right on his hip. Right on his hip and not allowing him to go right at all. No fake left is going to be happening. That's the only time you can really force a player. Now, we've gone over defense, foot speed. We've gone over shooting and dribbling. What else is left? Well, guess what? Rebounds are very important. Rebounds pay bills. Quite literally, Kawhi Leonard has said that. As a guard, how can I get a rebound if I'm a guard? Quite easily. You close out on your defender. You stutter, you don't go jumping out. You don't go, oh crap, my man is shooting. No. You say, oh, my man is shooting. Stutter step out, and as soon as he takes that shot, you're not jumping. If he shoots a three, whatever, you're not going to block it. You're going to close out. Now, if that ball comes right back at you, you're in prime position to get that ball. You don't need to be battling with the big 7-footers, 6-footers down in the key. You just need to battle with your own player who you're guarding. And by stutter stepping out to him, you're going to be able to contest the shot and allow yourself to box out. So make sure, practice shooting and dribbling 30 minutes a day each if you're serious about playing basketball. Foot speed drills if you're serious about playing defense, and you better be if you want to get playing time, at least with the teams that I coach. Anyways, I hope that you've enjoyed today's video. I hope that these tips help you. I'm yelling because those guys are super duper loud, and I'll see you guys again tomorrow for another Twice a Day basketball video.